So this topic is quantity index numbers. So now, till now we have studied about how to calculate the price index, and price index was denoted with P01. Now we will see how we calculate the quantity index, that will be denoted with Q01. So the index number may also be constructed to measure a change in the physical quantity of the goods produced, goods consumed or goods sold. So we can calculate quantity index number with a simple method. Just we will be replacing Q in the place of P. That will become our quantity index, and that will be applicable for all our weighted aggregative formulas that we have discussed in the previous videos. So in for calculating, for example, if I take the example of Lespierre's method, we all have seen that the formula for Lespierre's for calculating the price index is sigma P1 Q0 divided by sigma P0 Q0 into 100. So now if I have to calculate the quantity index, so what I will do, I will be replacing Q in the place of P and P in the place of Q. So sigma, instead of P, I will be writing Q now. It will become Q1, P0. In place of Q, I am writing P. Now divided by, in place of P, I am writing Q. And in place of Q, I am writing P. So this becomes my formula. But instead of writing it like this, what will I do? I will simply always keep P at the front. So I am writing P0, Q1. P maybe with 1 or Q or 0, it hardly matters, but P should be kept in the front. So now what I have done is I have kept P in the front and Q at the back, divided by P will come further, Q will go back into 100. So instead of writing this, I will be writing it like that. So now it has become the Lespierre's formula of quantity index. So this is the formula of Lespierre for quantity index. Similarly, we can make changes to all the other formulas. Let us see the Pasquier's formula. You have seen that the Pasquier's formula for price index was this. So now if I have to write quantity index from here, what will I do? I will be replacing Q at the place of P and P at the place of Q. So Q and P divided by, here Q will come, here P will come. But I am not supposed to write the formula like this. So what will I do? P will be coming at the front, P1 Q1 divided by sigma P1 and Q0 into 100. So this will become my quantity index for the Pasquier's method. Similarly, we can calculate for Fisher also. If I will take the example of Fisher here. Now, if we take Fisher's method, the price index according to Fisher method was this. So now if I have to create quantity index from here, so what will I do? Sigma, here it will be Q1 P0, but I will be writing P0 in the front. It will be Q0 P0, so I will be writing P0 in the front. It will be Q1 P1, but I will write P1 in the front. It will be Q0 P1, like this. Now the same formula has been converted into the quantity index. So like this we can calculate the quantity index in any question. But just we will calculate these values, as we have seen in the previous videos how we calculate these values, because in the question we are given P and Q for base year as well as current year. So just take these four values from there, fill here, and you can calculate the quantity index in any formula.